This is part two of a presentation on frequency distributions. In part one, we talked about how to construct a frequency distribution. In this part, we're going to find out how to find the mean and standard deviation of a frequency distribution. You can see there it is. That's what we're going to be doing. And this is based on the Triola textbook, chapters 3, 2, and 3.3. You'll notice here it says there are two ways to do this. One is to use formulas. The second is to use the calculator. And we're going to learn how to do it on the calculator. And you see the calculator right over here that we are going to use. It's really quite easy. And by the way, we're going to be using values here for frequency distribution. And those come from the same problem that we worked on in part one of the frequency distribution presentation. So step one to do this is we're going to go to our lists. And the way we do that is to hit the stat key and the enter key. And there are our lists. In L1, we're going to type in the midpoints of our classes. Well, you notice here I already have some values in L1, and I want to get rid of those. And the way I get rid of those is I arrow up to, L1. Sorry, this is going to take me a minute. And we're going to hit clear and enter. And that eliminates all the numbers, all the values from that list. So if we go back to our steps here, in L1 we're going to type in the midpoints of each of our classes, and in L2 we're going to type in the frequency of each of our classes. And again, all of these values come from the problem that we worked on in part one of the frequency distribution presentation. So there are our class midpoints and frequencies. So we're going to type them in here. 64.5 is the first class midpoint. 74.5 is the next class midpoint. Oh, I made a mistake. Let's try that again. 104.5. I forgot to hit the enter key. Enter. 114.5. Enter. 124.5. Enter. So this tells us that right here we're on line 8, which means we have entered 7 values, and that's how many classes we have here, is 7 classes. Now we're going to move over to L2, which is our frequency column, and enter those numbers. 12, 14, 11, 1, 1, 0, and 1. So our entry of our midpoints and frequencies is now complete. Our next step is to hit stat. We're going to arrow over to calc and hit enter. So I hit the stat key. There you see calc. I'm going to arrow over to calc, and it's right where I want it to be, so I'm just going to go ahead and hit enter. Now, something to be aware of here. Some of you have newer calculators and some of you have older calculators. I have an older calculator, and that the format that you're going to see with the older calculator is just like what it shows right here. If you have a newer calculator, it's going to look a little bit different, and I'll talk about that in a second. So what we're going to do here on this calculator is the calculator is ready to calculate the mean and the standard deviation, but it needs to know which lists it needs to look at to find these things. So we have to tell it to look at list 1 and list 2. And the way we do that is we hit the second key and the one key, and that activates this little L1 right here. Then we hit the comma key, and then we have to tell it to look at list 2. So that's second 2, and there you see that on our calculator display, and that's good, and we're going to hit enter. Now, if you have one of the newer calculators, when you hit that stat calc enter, your screen is going to look something like this. It's going to say 1 var stats in little letters at the top, and then you will see list, frequency list, and calculate. And in that case, right after list, you want to put in L1. That again is second 1. After frequency list, you want to put in L2. And then you will arrow down to calculate. You will sort of highlight calculate the way it looks here. And then you will hit the enter key. And when you do that, you will get the same things we see over here. So now we are back together again. We're all seeing the same thing in our calculator. Remember, we are trying to calculate the mean and the standard deviation of this frequency distribution. The mean is this right here, and we say X bar. So there you see the X bar, and that's actually how you say it, is 76.75. That is the mean. And the standard deviation is this thing SX. You see SX right there. That is the standard deviation. I wrote 12.297, which we round to 12.3 or 12.30. That's the standard deviation. It's as simple as that. If you try to calculate the mean and standard deviation of this frequency distribution by hand, it would take you a half hour to an hour, and you would make mistakes. There are no mistakes here. As long as the numbers you enter are correct, the calculator will calculate these things correctly. This problem is a great illustration of how much time you can save by using the calculator. I just want to point out one thing, and that's about rounding. Many students have questions about, well, how do I know how many places to round these things to? The rule is this. You look at your data, and in this case, our data are our class midpoints. Those bits of data go to one decimal point, one decimal place. So in listing our descriptive statistics, we go to one more decimal place. So in this case, the X bar, the mean, was exactly 76.75. That's two decimal places, and that's exactly what we want for descriptive statistic when the data have one decimal place. The standard deviation was a little bit trickier. You can see here 12.297 blah, blah, blah. We want to round that to two decimal places. Well, the 7, and here I'll highlight the 7 there, the 7 turns the 9 into a 0, which turns the 2 into a 3. So when you round to two decimal places, you get 12.30, which the 0 doesn't change anything. You could just as easily write that as 12.3. So it's perfectly correct whether you write 12.3 or 12.30. So that is the easy way to calculate the mean and the standard deviation of a frequency distribution. And that is the end of this presentation.